Out of the annals of the strange and the incredible, accounts of nightmarish creatures often appear to challenge our credulity. Here is a story about one such creature, a fantastic creature called the Abominable Snowman.
It is true that no European can say that he has actually seen the Abominable Snowman, and no American either. But if you should ask some wise and scholarly old monk, he would tell you.
The Abominable Snowman? Why, yes, of course I have seen him. And so have several of my brothers here. He dwells in the Himalayas, and sometimes at night you can hear his great roar and his footsteps echoing down the valley. Come, I will show you a picture of him.
Then the monk would lead you to a lurid painting hanging on the wall. And you would see a monstrous creature of gigantic height and breadth. He stands on 2 feet like a man, and his skin is white. But he is covered with black hair, and his face is the face of a beast. And if you should travel into the neighboring countries of Nepal or Bhutan, and if you should speak of the matter to one of the Sherpas or other native groups that inhabit Central Asia, the thing that would startle you would be the close resemblance between the picture he paints in words and the picture that hangs on the monastery wall. For they have seen him with their own eyes, and they have heard his roar. But it must not be assumed that all Europeans are skeptical of his existence. There is, for example, Mr. H.W. Tillman, who led the expedition of 1938 to the peak of Mount Everest. In reporting on his adventures, Mr. Tillman referred to one rather mysterious and perplexing sight that he and his party stumbled on.
There were footprints, tracks of some sort. We found them in a snowfield in the Karakorams, far above the permanent snow line. They were round, the size and shape of an enormous soup plate. They ran in a double line for a considerable distance. All I can suggest is that they might have been made by this creature whom the Asiatics call the Abominable Snowman.
And then, of course, there was Miss MacDonald, an English lady of Dalimpong. She had been warned by the natives of Tibet to beware of the fabulous monster. But, like others before her, she had smiled tolerantly and continued on her way. Then, on a certain afternoon, as she was traversing a high mountain pass that led across the Tibetan border, she heard... It was not the roar of an avalanche. Miss MacDonald made that quite clear in her comments on it.
Oh, heavens, it was an animal, unquestionably. Why, it was so loud, so violent, that it actually shook the ground under my feet.
Yes, it is quite probable that this fantastic creature does live and breathe and roam the snow-capped peaks of the Himalayas. For otherwise, how can we explain the Asiatics' unquestioning faith in him and their unanimous agreement on his appearance? And how can we explain the tracks in the snow and the great roar that shook the earth? It seems, on the basis of the evidence available, quite likely that someday science will recognize the Abominable Snowman, not as a myth or a legend, but as a fact, incredible but true.